good afternoon. Good night, I'll be seeing you a little bit later. We've decided we're going to take an encapsulation of what we've been showing you for the last, in this new series of videos, the idea, the immediacy of the possibility for you to undergo an experience that will give you the light of heaven and the eternal love that is yours through the power of your Creator. The success ratio, what we term the capacity for dark form to reorganize in light associations, has been advancing rather rapidly. So, using a couple of lessons from your Savior, Jesus Christ, I would like to review the very fundamental nature of what I am presenting you with as what you ostensibly call me, the Savior of the world. Obviously, any idea of saviorship would be an idea that would be possible for you to be separate from the single reality of universal mind. We use universal mind in the sense that there is one life, and that that life is eternal, and that life will be life regardless of the form that it takes. As a human, as you define yourself, you are in a consciousness association of the thought forms on which you base your apparent reality. You are, in that regard, a decision-making apparatus. Do you see this with me? Can you see this? You are in a process of continually observing yourself objectively in a space-time association and defining yourself by your objective association. That cannot not involve decision. Okay, can you see that? So the first element that must be involved in my need to authenticate through my light relationship your illuminate possibility is very simply that the decision is up to you. Say that to me. The decision is up to me.
The decision is up to me.
Yes. We have a large crowd here, as you can tell. So we're starting out with the fundamental admission of that the decision is up to you. If that is true, okay, it cannot not be, if the entirety of the decision is up to you, it cannot not be that this world of apparent chaos, loneliness, and death is a contractual association of your own mind and is indeed contained only in you. Do you see that? So what are we going to give you now? We're going to give you what we know is certain, that is the inherent capacity to decide that you would rather be in heaven than here, very simply because somewhere contained within the elements of the idea of yourself, you are searching for a solution which is apparently not within this continuum of consciousness association. There, I get a breath. And as you, if you remember the other videos, what I said to you, the time has come at last, hopefully, where you are going to simply say, I've had enough of the decisional possibilities contained within my human conceptual frame of reference. There must be an alternative that I can find. And as I told you previously, I'm going to represent that alternative to you. Now, the lesson that is going to be contained in the Course in Miracles from your Savior Jesus that will justify that will be lesson 152. I'm going to go on to the other two factors that will be involved in the finality of your decision to simply disappear. What? It's very possible if you should decide at this time that you have had enough of the factoring of your own conceptual association for you to just simply disappear. What will be here? Nothing. Okay? This world is a factoring of your objective conceptual association contained within your dream of association with yourself. When you change your mind, it's impossible that the world will not change. That will be the second factor involved in the mechanisms of attempting to teach you the reality of your singularity in association with universal mind. Now let's review it. Number one was, the power of decision is mine. Okay. Number two, which will be lesson 188, will say very plainly that that decision must and can only be made at this time. Help me with this now. The decision is mine, and the power to decide can only be now. All of the ideas of the sequentiality of time that have set terms for you in old form relationships, where you had to justify the body in the sequential evidence of rotting and decaying because you believed that life somehow was connected to carbon and hydrogen and oxygen, and that you were somehow disposed to be trapped with powers outside of yourself that set terms for what you must be. So the decision is yours, isn't it? The power to decide now is yours, based on our teaching, because there's only going to be now. And thirdly, and most importantly, and this is really the negation of the necessity for you to defend yourself at all, okay, is that you really have no other choice. Lesson 200 is going to say that the peace of God for which you have been searching is all that there is. Okay? So here I sit with you in a factor of a definition that you have given me in this little place of containment. I am representing to you in a body form a reflection of your mind that is offering you a solution to your problem. I am offering you now a solution to your problem. I am a projection of your mind association in a later time factor of your consciousness reality. Thank you for hearing that. The decision to come alone into the studio and to begin to share with you the act of the enlightenment of our minds in the inevitability of the entirety or immediacy of the factor involved in the totality of consciousness will be of great value to you. I guess. I'm not certain what I said. I'm going to turn just for a moment to this Course in Miracles, which obviously, if you would look at it, you can see immediately that the mind that is formulating and has formulated this association is offering you a power that cannot be denied except by yourself. This is lesson 152. The power of decision is my own. Are you ready? No one can suffer loss unless it be his own decision. Oh, come now. Do you mean that I lose intentionally? How else will you know you're a human being? If the power is in you, okay, to justify the possibility of gain, how would it not be associated with loss? You literally must lose in order to exist within your own conceptual associations, for goodness sake. No one suffers pain except his choice elects this state for him. Having made the choice to justify your own association with yourself, you will live in the necessity to become old and wrinkled and rotting and dying in this carbon-hydrogen association, very simply because you actually believe within the framework of your own dream or nightmare that that's who you are. Okay, remember the title to this, The Power of Decision Is My Own. No one can grieve, nor fear, nor think him sick unless these are the outcomes that he wants. This is all right with you? I know you don't like it. You're trying to study that in relationship with your own concepts. Don't do it. I'll give you one more and then we'll review it. And no one dies without his own consent. Nothing occurs but represents your wish, and nothing is omitted that you choose, and that's your problem. Okay? So I've got you somehow alone here, I hope now, and for just a moment, you are making an admission of the possibility that you would be able to literally, using the power of your Creator, which is what you are, to make a decision right now to say very simply, I've had enough of this formulation of myself. I would prefer to be as I was created in heaven. Okay? I'm going to use the factor of whoever I seem to be in a condition of projected association in this world with, I'm speaking of myself now, to use as a vehicle of my awakening, since the assurance I am receiving from him appears to be at variance with the world that I had constructed. He is informing me, and I am informing you now in my present tense, that your kingdom is not of this world, and the decision to return to heaven where you are from is within you, and that decision can be made by you now. All right? Now, to help you with this just for a minute, if you want to stay with me, the factor of your conceptual consciousness is deciding all the time. Are you aware of that? Are you aware that you were trained as a human being to utilize the consciousness of your self-identity to justify your associations with yourself? I gave you the indication of the power of your mind. It's time for you to understand that the power of mind is what you are, and your decision to continue to factor within the limitations of your own conceptual form are exactly why you are here. All right? Now, obviously, it wouldn't seem to you that you have decided somewhere to be in this world and suffer the pain of what appears to constitute it. Yet, if you'll share with me the reasonableness of my certainty that if truth is going to be true, nothing else will be true. And your determination to justify yourself in the truth of your aggregation of thought form cannot be overcome except by your decision not to adhere to it. Perhaps we'll get to that in this lesson. We'll try just a little more. Okay. Here is your world complete in all of its details. Here is its whole reality for you. It is only here that salvation lies. And the next paragraph is going to say, this seemed very extreme to you. I'm talking to you out there for a minute. That's very extreme to you. But if I'm offering you this power, wouldn't you rather have this be true than the alternative that you have given yourself? That you're at the mercy of the energies of the universe, that you're a little thing destined to remain in this sequential continuum of time and never be able to know what's out there? Never be able to travel beyond the stars? Never be able to share with me the certainty that you're one hell of a lot more than you're pretending to be? The amazing thing about this, that if you release the necessity for the defense of yourself, you will immediately begin to expand your consciousness-making decision very simply because all power of the mind is given unto you in heaven and earth. Is this true, John?
Yes.
That's John as a cameraman. He's smiling at me. Is that true? If the power is given to you under heaven and earth to make the decision, why not take a chance that what I'm telling you is true? I could be wrong, but when I look at your condition, everything being equal, wouldn't you rather believe that the decision to remain and suffer pain and death is with you, and that through changing your mind you can discover who you really are? I hope so. The difficult part you have with this is the uncompromising nature with which I present it to you. And I know that your conceptual mind reduces it to the idea of altruism. I've tried this with you before. Let's skip a little bit and try a little 152. Salvation is nothing but the recognition that the truth is true and nothing else is true. This you've heard before, but you haven't accepted both parts of it. If you did, you'd see immediately that you cannot not be true and whole. Truth is true. Everybody goes, well, I certainly know that. But did you know that nothing else is true? And if nothing else is true, say to me, everything must be true.
Everything must be true.
Well, of course. I know you don't like that because you like to be able to define things within your own association as true or false, that you can remain in the factor of your body identity. The next lesson that we're going to from this is going to declare to you the immediacy of the possibility for you to undergo an illuminate experience based on an instantaneous cellular reassociation of your body form contained within this factoring of your dream of death. And I'm not certain you're going to like it, but it's going to be true. The simple fact of the matter is if this decision, okay, to stay here is being made by you, the decision to leave can also be made by you. It requires a fundamental admission that if truth is true, there will be no truth outside of yourself, because nothing can be outside of you. Then the nature of this exposure to my mind in the certainty that our minds are sharing this singular reality will become very valuable to you, and you'll begin to enjoy the idea that you don't have to get old and sick and die and lose the things that you love. Or would you prefer to? See? I put you back into a situation that may necessitate your need to actually look at whether you would prefer to remain within the options. Remember the other video? The options of the pertainment of yourself that offer you existence, a struggle, and apparent success, and then a demise or an obliviation are simply absurd and not real. So the first factor involved in this was the power of decision is my own, and I have decided, okay, to accept my rightful place, and I'm going to go on to this lesson, as co-creator with God of the universe. I'm going to admit that all power is given unto me in heaven and earth. I'm going to admit that I am whole and perfect as God created me. I'm going to share with you my experience of the certainty that through the forgiveness and love of our Savior Jesus Christ, that we can return now to and assume our rightful place in the kingdom of God. So the power of decision is yours. All right. Let's turn just for a minute here to the necessity for your admission of the immediacy of that solution. The Course is replete with its determination that you recognize the continuity of thought that is determining the outcome that you want within your own association of mind and body is actually simultaneous, and all of it is going on right now. The idea of the sequentiality of time is what has bound you to an inability to see the immediacy of my offering. We'll jump ahead just for a moment to, before I get to 200, which is going to say there is no peace except the peace of God. Let's go just for a moment to a lesson that certainly is going to offend all of you so-called spiritual seekers. It says the peace of God is shining in me now. Okay, I'll try it once more with you. The peace of God is shining in you now. I remember prior to my illumination, I always questioned what spiritual seekers were, because obviously what they had to be seeking for was a God that was going to justify their associations here. And if that were true, all of their spiritual searching would be fairly meaningless. Okay. Now, if they were able to find it, how would they possibly justify it within their own mind? There's a little curiosity that I used to share with a lot of you in our search for God, when anyone in their right mind would see immediately that there is a whole universally creating God, that you could not be separate from it. Now, since you have taken a position of separation, the decision to return to heaven must be a part of your possibility reality. The idea that you could actually be separate from eternal life is, of course, absurd and insane, as we hopefully indicated on the other videos that we offered you. So this decision that you're going to make now, that you do not want to be in this world, is going to verify in an increasing discovery of your mind that you don't belong here. And this is the lesson that I hope I have led you to. If I've gotten you this far so you can recognize your alienship here, okay, the solution will be enhanced by the light of heaven, which is simply a reflection of your own reality. Should we try the sentence? Okay. Why wait for heaven? Those who seek the light are merely covering their eyes. Okay? You're looking around, justifying your existent association. You find momentary happiness in your dedication to remain in the conflict of God and replicate the possibility of the entirety of your association with God. Merely covering your eyes is sort of interesting metaphor, because what it says is you are intentionally seeking the darkness in order to justify the pain that is necessary for you to exist within a time frame. When I look back at it, the idea that somebody would seek for God and not be able to find him caused me to deny there could be a God. That did not relieve me from my chaotic association, but certainly it placed on me the responsibility for the decision-making process, which I began to exercise very successfully in this world. The problem was not that. The problem is, the more successful I became, the more obvious it became to me that no matter how successful I was, nothing was really going to happen, except I was going to rot and sink back down. Excuse me, I'm getting a little excited here. I believe some of you are starting to hear this. So this decision to return to heaven, and this is so beautifully expressed in this lesson, is yours to make. And it says, the light is in them now. Enlightenment is but a recognition, not a change at all. And that's tough. You like the idea of a phenomenal enlightenment. The idea that I will suddenly turn to light and disappear from here. What good is that going to do you? All I'll do is be gone and you'll still be here. Enlightenment is not a change, it's a recognition within your own mind. As you become more and more enlightened in the factors of the association of your own mind, you will still be you. You're not going to be somebody else. You're going to be you no matter how you factor yourself. Are you getting excited with me? Hi. So the decision is going to be yours. And the second factor is, the peace of God is shining in me now. Okay? Enlightenment is about a recognition, not a change at all. So suddenly you're looking out, and very likely in this new continuum, associations of body, thought, form are literally disappearing right before your eyes. It's impossible that you can recognize this, because you remain a constitution of a definition of your own thought forms. Can you see this with me? All right. But it's impossible that if what I am reading to you and offering you, Okay. Within our form association of your existent identity as a human being on this little planet is not true, or how is it that you're able to sit with me now and listen? Try this one. Light is not of the world, yet you who bear the light in you are alien here as well. The idea that light is not of the world is a very interesting a phenomenal observation, because light will be light and truth and love and certainty of God. Darkness cannot be identified except in the association of the nothingness of your conceptual form identity. All right? So here's some tough ideas. Everyone that you're meeting in this world has brought with him the fundamental admission of the certainty that he comes from heaven and is in fact an alien here. And that will be what the sentence will say. The light came with you from your native home and stayed with you because it is your own. It is the only thing you bring with you from him who is your source. It shines in you because it lights your home and leads you back to where it came from, and you are at home. All right? So those are the two factors that we were involved in. Number one, that the decision to depart this world can be made by you right here and right now. I am here within this factor of your association of conceptual self, offering you the truth of your selfness. Now, if you want to call that self-identity, I have no objection to it. If you will accept from me and from your Savior Jesus Christ the certainty that all of the power of the universe, even in a decision-making factor, is given to you. Could you see that? See, nothing can be taken away from you. Remember that other lesson? If you decide you're going to stay here, and you're going to suffer, and you're going to get old, and you're going to die, and you're going to maintain you can't travel to the stars, that you can never know the reality of universal life, so it will be with you. I would remind you that somewhere within this continuum of association, I am now present with you. If I am present with you, offering you the completion of an alternative, it must be that you have exercised that alternative if you will further admit to me the impossibility of the sequential association of thought form. All right? So heaven is a decision that I can make because the light of heaven is shining in me now. What two things do we have now? We have the certainty that the decision can be made by you since you literally have decided to remain here based on the evidence of the provisions that you have been given within this spatial reference. All right? And that I am with you now offering you the end of that dream. I like the idea that the power of my mind is the deciding factor in the solution that I sought. That required only one basic admission in my part that brought about my enlightenment. And that I want to remind you with now. And that was the admission that all of the factors of my decisions had led me to the same conclusions. All right. But the idea of undergoing a bodily experience of light is the simple admission of the new terms that have been set by your physicists in regard to their certainty of the unreality of objective association, so that perhaps you can share with me in this new light factor our determination that we are representing the entirety of a formulation of mine based on what appears to be a molecular association of our own form, yet cannot deny to us the certainty of eternal life. All right? Somebody handed me this card today, and I'm going to hold it up, and I'm going to have you read it just for a moment, if you will, for me. Can you see that all right? Begin. Can you read it? Read.
My home awaits me, I will hasten there. If I so choose, I can depart this world entirely. It is not death which makes this possible, but it is a change of mind about the power of the world. If I believe it has a value as I see it now, so will it still remain for me.
Uh-oh.
But if I see no value in the world as I behold it, nothing that I want to keep as mine or search for as a goal, it will depart from me.
Oh my.
For I have not sought for illusions to replace the truth. Father, my home awaits my glad return. Your arms are open and I hear your voice. What need have I to linger in a place of vain desires and of shattered dreams when heaven can so easily be mine?
That was a prayer at the end, wasn't it? Huh? Do you mind the idea of the anthropocentric nature of this association? Read this. Will you read this as a prayer to me, just the bottom page?
Father, my home awaits my glad return. Your arms are open and I hear your voice. What need have I to linger in a place of vain desires and of shattered dreams when heaven can so easily be mine?
Good for you. You get all the arguments from conceptual mind about God having arms. I got arms. You have arms. What's wrong with God having arms? Except some ethereal nonsense that somehow you will not be you as you have defined yourself. I didn't mean to get into that. Is this all right with you? That's one of my favorite prayers, because it expresses a gratitude of my certainty that I am as my Creator created me. And that as we move up to lesson 200, you would think that somewhere contained within the first 200 lessons, it would end up with more than the simple declaration that there is only the peace of God. Yet the fact of the matter remains is that you are whole and perfect as God created you. Okay. Obviously, that's going to require your acceptance. But remember what I gave you in the first offering. The decision not to accept it remains a formulation within your own mind. Now, for those of you who believe that somehow I have tricked you by declaring to you that all power is given to you in heaven and earth, this power comes from God, and that you may decide to remain and suffer pain and death, I want you to understand this with me. There's no possibility that you can be separate from the love of God. There is no possibility that the factor of the relationship of time, space and time, that justifies the conflict that you feel within your own conceptual mind could have anything to do with reality at all. If you will accept my assurance that this certainty can be arrived within you by the illuminant factor of the resurrection of our Savior, Jesus Christ, if you want to use him, will give us that certainty one. And that's hopefully what we're doing now. All right, now we have the two things. The peace of God is shining in me now, and the power of decision is mine. But if we go to lesson 200, which is the last formal lesson within the course, it is going to say, there is no peace except the peace of God, and it's going to request that you quit looking for something else. Stop looking within your mind for what you're never going to be able to find. Be reasonable with me. How many times are you going to try to decide to justify once again your apparent condition of separation from the universe that's going to force you to define within your own mind a longevity that is becoming so ridiculous within its limited scope that perhaps it's necessary for you now to see a real alternative. Seek you no further. There is nothing but the peace of God. You will not find peace except the peace of God. Accept this fact. Talking to you. You there. No, I'm not talking to the world. My concern is only about you. Remember what we said? This world is a construct of your mind. Okay? You're all alone in the universe searching for the solution that appears to be a part of this world. Yet here I am entering your dream, offering you this lesson. Huh? Would you like to have this be true? Accept this fact and save yourself the agony of yet more bitter disappointment, bleak despair, and sense of icy hopelessness and doubt. Seek you no further. There is nothing else for you to find except the peace of God, unless you're determined to stay miserable and suffer. So how's that going with you? The 20 lessons that follow 200, if we had time to do it, are going to introduce you to the immediacy of the expression of a single determination that cannot not bring you the result for which you search. Because it's an admission that I am not a body, I am free, I am still as God created me. And that will be the persistence of your newfound reality. And that will bring about your illumination. Remember that within the devices of this mind training, we have continually offered you the solution through the releases of the defense of your conceptual association. Yet there is no power in the universe that can prevent you individually from exercising the decision that you believe is possible to be separate from your total reality. And we belabor it a little bit because finally I'd like to have you see what the immediacy of our condition together is. So it's a little disappointing perhaps to you to do 200 days of association and then be faced with this. But all you ever really had to be told is not this. All I really had to tell you in your dream, a nightmare of death, was it's not this. I never in any way or with any whole mind ever justify to a current conceptual association any part of it as being real. There is nowhere within any offering that has ever occurred in the invention of a God who became a whole God in the certainty that the inventive mind could share in the entirety of God through the power of its own mind. That is an inclusion of your mind, okay, would not see immediately that what I'm offering you is true within you, and I'm not certain what I said. But I do want you to understand that the offering I'm giving you is very real, and that if you can accept it even initially with the idea of the possibility, the enhancement of it within this cycle of time is going to increase very rapidly. Remember the terms we set in chapter 13 of the text when we said that time lasted but a moment in your mind with no effect on eternity at all? And so is all time gone? And actually you're back at home in heaven. Okay? Now, the defenses you'll employ will say, yeah, but how come I'm here in this association? All I am offering you is the entirety of the solution. In no way can I justify your determination to remain here, because your justification to remain here is why you're here. But I can't offer you the solution contained within your entirety. Okay? This is the final point to which each one must come at last, to lay aside all hope of finding happiness where there is none, of being saved by what can only hurt, of making peace of chaos, joy of pain, and heaven out of hell. Attempt no more to win through losing, nor to die to live. You cannot be asking but for defeat, because that's your alternative. So it's nice that we get a chance to come together once more in the final episode that you intend now to perform in the certainty that you are undergoing a metamorphosis. Okay, well, you want to look at it with me now? Should we try it just for a minute? I'm looking directly at you and our association with the certainty that the self that I represent to you is the self of you through the self that is God in our association with each other. Is that okay with you? Okay. In the Course in Miracles, Jesus Christ teaches you that God has but one Son, and that that Son is you. He declares to you that if you appear to be separate from reality, that the saviorship of that apparent separation must depend on you because there's nothing outside of your mind. That's very altruistic, and it's also very true. All right? Notice that our emphasis must remain on the necessity for you to have this experience within your own continuity of reality, not separating your mind and body, but including instead the certainty of the immediacy of the thought form mind light association. Okay? We're going to wrap up this first hour. How much time is left in the first hour?
Oh, excuse me. 15 minutes.
Okay. We're going to wrap this up now with attempts to make some direct contacts with God. And they're going to be based pretty basically on lesson 200, because the 20 lessons after 200 will say that I am not a body, and that I am free, and that I am as God created me. And I want to share the quietness that we may use in order to begin to establish some communication. Okay, I'm going to offer you an exposure of light. And I hope somewhere within the reflections of your mind association with yourself. Remember on the other video where we said that you are self-contained? Some of you have accepted the idea that objectivity does not communicate. Okay? That is, if there are separate objects, they can only represent the apparent conditional reality that gives them a definition of location. Okay? You have accepted the fundamental premise that communication must be whole to be real, which is nothing but a statement in the activity of truth being true, that truth is true and nothing else is true. The admission that all formulations of objective association of human condition are non-communicative, okay, has been the goal of our expressions, that you'll stop trying to decide within your own conceptual factor the solutions you want within yourself and in this world, if this world is indeed a projection of your objective association. Remember what we said on the last video? That each one inhabits his own association with himself, projects from him that association, and begins to define objectively what he is. What an absurdity. At the very minimum, it requires the admission that the thought form traveled at the speed of light. And by the time the reflection returned to him, it would be too late. Those of you who are going to review the first 40 lessons of the Course in Miracles, where it says very plaintively, I see only the past. And that's why the decision to address you now must contain the possibility for you to undergo the immediacy of an experience that will show you now. Okay? What does Jesus say? Jesus says, I will be with you even unto the ends of the earth. I will represent the entirety of your Christhood in the certainty that you are perfect as I am, since I am you, in our certainty of the factor of reality based on a single creative source. And that's my offering to you now. Notice how it contains all of the elements that you have defined as nihilism. There's nothing in here that says anything except come home. You have not found your happiness in foreign places and in alien forms that have no meaning to you, though you sought to make them meaningful. This world is not where you belong. Who said that? Jesus. I'm saying it to you. You're saying it to me. We had a fundamental agreement based on a necessity to justify our separation that we would find a communication separate from our source. We cannot be successful at it simply because time itself is not successful in its relationship with the inevitability of eternity. Time fails because it is time. And while you may hold it in a definition of yourself, you cannot not suffer the conflict of the justification for a location contained within that continuum. And this is the alternative that I'm offering you now. Don't look for happiness where it isn't. Okay? You don't belong here. I'm going to come into your dream. Did I take a chance with this? I'm going to come into your dream just for a second. And I'm going to offer you the entirety of the solution if you're willing to accept it from me. You remember this. The power that I'm employing is the power of universal mind. The power that I'm offering you is the power that we are. It has nothing to do with the formulation of your conceptual egotistical associations whatsoever. It's a process of the conversion of your conceptual form to the certainty of a singular reality. It is literally coming from time to eternal life. Heretofore, you have defined life as a temporal association of form that somehow justified the necessity for you to augment your apparent limited self with form identities that have bound you to the potential of possibility of separation. And it's not true. So we're going to meditate for just a moment in a what you term a transcendental possibility of the immediacy of a contact with the light that is all around you. There's an expression in the A Course where Jesus, and this is my offering to you, you may depart in a blaze of light and you will be gone and there will be no world and there will never have been a world. You brought the world with you when you came. It's contained within the fabric of your mind association. And when you leave here, there will be no world, nor will there ever have been one. It's important that you see I'm not taking any of the memory factors that you have constructed in this very short period in order to justify your reality. I would point out to you that in slow time, you've been here for about 12,000 million years. About 12 billion years, measuring that against the 40,000 years that constitute your apparent conceptual association with heaven, and you can see how actually short the time has been since your arrival into the chaos and your discovery of the alternative. Can you see that with me? You are a very recent entry into the cycle of the evolutionary process of returning from chaos to reality. So you'd be happy with that. Time lasted but a moment in your mind. And the repetition that you experience now in the non-defense of yourself is going to cause you a great deal of happiness. I trust. I want it to. So as this video ends, if you'll take the, I want the peace, there is no peace but the peace of God. Okay. There is no peace except the peace of God because he has one son who cannot make a world in opposition to God's will and to his own, which is the same as his. How beautiful singularity can be expressed in apparent dualistic associations if you are willing to accept fundamentally that you are not the source of your own power. Do you see? If the source of your power is contained within space-time, it's going to have to be used up in the potential of the black hole and subsequently disappear. Okay, do you see that? Entropy, what an amazing idea. Somehow the universe is going to get used up. The idea that you are contained within the power of your own limitation certainly would justify that. In fact, life is eternal. In fact, we are sharing for a moment a mistake, if you want to call it that, that occurred in the break in communication that has now been reestablished. And there's a little static in it yet, but each moment we are improving through a technique of a training device that we are employing for you to release the defenses of your concepts and leave clean the possibility of the entrance of that light into your reality. That's going to make you very happy, and I see some of you are becoming happier by the moment there. Is that okay with you? What you can really say about this experience, you right there, is that suddenly it was new. It doesn't seem really to compare with any of your conceptual associations, very simply because it's incomparable. Okay, it's a condition of reality that is now formulating in you in this new world of possibility that is not within the constitution of the dark form, but remains a continual conversion thereof. Whatever that was. Lesson 200. Peace is the bridge that everyone will cross to leave this world behind. But peace begins within the world perceived as different and leading from this fresh perception to the gate of heaven and the way beyond. Okay? The idea that there could be anything but the entirety of the peace of God is impossible. But as long as you remain in any form of conflict, you will conflict with heaven, because any form of conflict would be denial of the entirety of the peace of God. So to that extent, peace, the peace of mind that you are finding now, is a bridge to heaven. And that bridge can be augmented by the continual release of the defense of your dark form associations that will give you an establishment or a surety on which you base crossing the bridge. That is the certainty that that power of bringing your old thought forms into this present condition will show you immediately your association with heaven, I hope. So what have we said, and then we'll end this hour. We said that the decision is yours, that the power to make the decision is given to you, and that the power of the decision to remain in pain and to suffer and to lose the things that you love are a constitution of your determination to deny and attack through separation the reality of your single creative source. Next, we employed you or made you active in the idea of the immediacy of that occurrence. And third, we told you that the occurrence is inevitable. All right? If you look at me with me, all we really says is you are in a condition of maturation coming from potential thought form to the certainty through this revolutionary process of the enlightening of your own mind that you are perfect as God created you. That will suffice for now. And it's fun to look at what happens after, the final sentence is, there is no peace except the peace of God, and I am glad and thankful that that is so. In the review lessons, Jesus is going to speak in the first person to you for a moment, because at the end of His Course in Miracles, He wants you to know that He has been with you in this episode, as I am expressing to you, and that I'm about to leave here. All right? But I would never leave you comfortless in that the self that's going to represent you within yourself is our self together. And you'll like that, won't you? You want that to be true. He says something, okay? He says something, and he says it like this. To him, I offer this review for you. I place you in his charge and let him teach you what to do and say and think each time you turn to him. He's speaking of your own whole self. Can you see that? Until you emerged in your own selfness, you needed a little help from me. But the only help I could possibly give you is the certainty of our singular self. So in that sense, Jesus Christ, or any enlightened mind, if you take your place, will simply represent the entirety of the inevitability that all human beings possess within themselves, the reality of their own Christhood. All right? And that particularly, no conflict is being suffered in the association of the entirety of your creative energy of eternal reality and that contained within your own conceptual mind. That literally, this world is over and gone, and was gone a long time ago. Okay? So there's going to be 20 lessons following the review that say very simply, I'm not a body, I am free, for I am still as God created me. I'm going to do lesson 202, which is the second lesson, and that will be the end of this. It says this, I will be still an instant and go home. Why would I choose to stay an instant more when I do not belong and where I do not want to stay, where God himself has given me his voice to call me home? So my decision to leave has now become a part of what I am. I am not a body. I am free. I am still as God created me. Here is that offering to you now. I may be seeing you sooner than you think. The reality of the new light forms are surrounding you. Look through them. Remember in the teaching, man? Look through. Don't accept your own projections. Release them, and you begin to have this experience. You keep that up, I'll be seeing you much sooner than you think. The peace of God is in me now. There's a chamber, there's a place that I can go where I can feel a relief from all of the torturous avenues that I had previously sought as solutional possibilities. And I see at last that the light extending forever has become a part of my whole mind, and I am grateful that that is so. Perhaps I'll see you again. Yeah. You look for me where I am, and you'll find me for sure. I'll be with you in just a moment. That goes for you, too. I'll be seeing you in a minute. There's a lot of excitement abroad about the possibility of an immediate communication with God, despite all of this world's determination not to admit to the possibility. We're here now, and we have come to show you the place where you can come with us. Whole and perfect as you were created. I'll see you soon. Here's a true story. Listen. Into eternity, where all is one, there crept a tiny mad idea at which the Son of God remembered not to laugh. In his forgetting did the thought become a serious idea and possible of both accomplishment and real effects. Together, we can laugh them both away and understand that time cannot intrude upon eternity. It is a joke to think that time can come to circumvent eternity, which means there is no time. No one asleep and dreaming in the world remembers his attack upon himself. No one believes there really was a time when he knew nothing of a body and could never have conceived this world as real. He would have seen at once that these ideas are one illusion too ridiculous for anything but to be laughed away. How serious they now appear to be, and no one can remember when they would have been met with laughter and with disbelief. We can remember this if we but look directly at their cause, and we will see the grounds for laughter, not a cause for fear. Time lasted but an instant in your mind with no effect upon eternity. And so is all time past, and everything exactly as it was before the way to nothingness was made. The tiny tick of time in which the first mistake was made, and all of them within that one mistake, held also the correction for that one, and all of them that came within the first. And in that tiny instant, time was gone, for that was all it ever was. What God gave answer to is answered and is gone. Each day and every minute in each day and every instant that each minute holds, you but relive the single instant when the time of terror took the place of love. And so you die each day to live again until you cross the gap between the past and the present, which is not a gap at all. Such is each life, a seeming interval from birth to death and on to life again, a repetition of an instant gone by long ago that cannot be relived. And all of time is but the mad belief that what is over is still here and now. The present is before time was and will be when time is no more. In it are all things that are eternal, and they are one. Their continuity is timeless, and their communication is unbroken, for they are not separated by the past. Only the past can separate, and it is nowhere. Welcome to the real here and now. Welcome home.
There'll be a change in the weather, change in the sea. Before long, there'll be a change in me. My walk will be different. Talking my name, ain't nothing about me gonna be the same. I'm gonna change my way of living, boy. That ain't enough. Well, then I'll change the way I